once loved Yab, and through the years we will treasure with a joy beyond measure. The gifts you have given, we shall never forget.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. And welcome. Today is the 142nd time, as Mr. Furlong mentioned, that St. Peter's Prep has gathered for commencement. Provides me, as principal, one last opportunity on behalf of the entire prep community to thank our graduates and their families for giving us the privilege of being a part of your lives for the past 4 years. In a moment, our program will begin, as it has for over 100 years, in a prayer. Prep's Director of Campus Ministry, Mr. John Dougherty, will give our invocation, and following that, the National Anthem. So I would ask that all please stand now for our prayer and the National Anthem. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. In his letter to the Philippians, St. Paul writes, "Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank Him for all that He has done." After a year like this one, it can be tempting to look back with regret, to focus on all the things we missed and all that we've lost. That grieving is important. But today, I invite you to follow St. Paul's advice and to look on your prep experience with gratitude. Be thankful for the times that we had together, for the opportunities to learn and grow and form a brotherhood. Be thankful for the people who walked beside you on this journey, who celebrated with you in the good times, and who supported you when you didn't think you could keep going. Be thankful for the ways that you have grown and the ways that you made an impact on the prep community simply by being here and by being yourselves. And know that we are deeply grateful for each and every one of you. Loving God, we pray today for the class of 2020. Pray in thanksgiving for the experiences they have shared together, the bonds they have formed, and the community that they found at Prep. We thank you, Lord, for everyone who has encouraged and supported these graduates as they have grown into the young men who stand before us today. We are grateful for the parents, siblings, friends, teachers, and coaches who offered guidance to these young men on their journey to adulthood. And lastly, we pray for you, gentlemen, that as you move ahead, you remain open to growth, dedicated to service, and always willing to strive for the Magis. We ask God to be with you as you go forth from St. Peter's. We pray that you will always be aware of His great love for you. Bless us, Father, and help each of us to never stray from our responsibility to you and to one another. We ask for this as we ask for all things, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Again, it is my great honor to preside here at the 142nd commencement of St. Peter's Prem. I'd like to begin today with a couple of introductions. I'm joined on the stage from your left to right by Mr. John Doherty, our Director of Campus Ministry, Father John Mullen, the Guidance Department, representing the Jesuit community, Dr. Michael Gomez, our President, Ms. Belkis Dahlem, Guidance Counselor, Director of Diversity and Inclusion, who will deliver the address to graduates later in the program, Mr. Robert Furlong, our Vice Principal, and Mr. John Morris, our Dean of Students. To the left and right of the stage are Prep's distinguished faculty, administration, staff, and trustees, and by far the most important people here today, the class of 2020. You've been an exceptional force for us here at St. Peter's Prep. For many members of the faculty and staff, particularly those who have been here for some time, each class has its own personality, spirit, and style all its own, and you have certainly not disappointed us in that way. From retreat houses to athletic fields, debates to plays, from soup kitchens to study sessions, you, the members of the class of 2020, embody all that Jesuit education looks to foster. You are open to growth, intellectually competent, religious, loving, and committed to doing justice. To begin our program this afternoon, I'd like to acknowledge academic achievements of the class of 2020. We are particularly proud of the 71 members of the class who are graduating today with honors, 3.7 or higher cum laude GPA, or high honors, 4.0 or over magna cum laude, for maintaining a superior grade point average over 4 years at Prep. This is noted in the program, and as graduates are recognized on the stage, they will be designated cum laude or magna cum laude. In a moment, I will ask Mr. Robert Furlong, our Vice Principal, and Mr. John Morris, our Dean of Students, to announce a number of special awards. Each recipient should please stand at his place when his name is called. So now I'd like to ask Mr. Furlong to please come forward.
The National Merit Scholarship Competition acknowledges the academic achievement of high school students based on PSAT results. Only the top 5% of the more than 1.5 million high school students eligible for National Merit Scholarships are recognized by that organization each year. Prep is extremely proud to have 7 students who were commended in the 2020 National Merit Scholarship Competition. Please hold your applause until the entire roster has been called. I ask the following to stand for recognition: Suvan Bhatt, Daniel Gao, George Garcia, Gabriel Gudez, Anthony Ionta, Kevin Tierney, Victor Tyne. Congratulations, gentlemen. The College Board recognizes as outstanding Hispanic Latino high school scholars students who have achieved a minimum PSAT score for their region and a junior year cumulative GPA of 3.5 or higher. I ask the following students to please stand and be recognized as a 2019-2020 scholar in the National Hispanic Recognition Scholars Program. Please hold your applause until the entire roster has been called: George Garcia, Gabriel Gudez, Victor Tyne, Peter Vasquez. Congratulations, gentlemen. I am pleased to present the following academic awards for school year 2019-2020. We will announce awards in four major groups: Fine and Performing Arts first, Classical and Modern Languages second, followed by English, Religion, and History, and finally, Mathematics and Science. Please hold your applause until the 10 or so names and their awards in each group have been called. Each recipient should stand as his name is called. For academic excellence, St. Peter's Prep bestows the following Fine and Performing Arts awards: a Gold Award in Visual Arts is presented to Jonas Eaton and Tyler McCanka, ex aequo. A Silver Award in Visual Arts is presented to Connor Obara. A Gold Award in Instrumental Music is presented to Michael Uy. A Silver Award in Instrumental Music is presented to Matthew Cugliari. A Gold Award in Vocal Music is presented to Ryder Klein. A Silver Award in Vocal Music is presented to Christopher Shepherd. A Gold Award in Creative Writing is presented to Peter Vasquez and Gabriel Clément, ex aequo. Congratulations, gentlemen. We bestow the following Classical and Modern Language awards. A Gold Award in Latin is presented to Daniel Dow. A Silver Award in Latin is presented to Colin Lemke. A Gold Award in French is presented to Eunice Chibubi. A Gold Award in German is presented to Christopher Shepherd. A Gold Award in Italian is presented to Anthony Ionta. A Gold Award in Spanish is presented to George Garcia and Antonio Caligari, ex aequo. Congratulations, gentlemen. We bestow the following English, History, and Religion awards. A Gold Award in English is presented to Eunice Chibubi. A Silver Award in English is presented to Victor Tyne. A Gold Award in History and Social Sciences is presented to Alexander Gray and George Garcia, ex aequo. A Silver Award in History and Social Sciences is presented to Anthony Ionta. A Gold Award in Religion is presented to James Conti. A Silver Award in Religion is presented to George Garcia. Congratulations, gentlemen. And finally, we bestow the following Mathematics and Science awards. A Gold Award in Mathematics is presented to Anthony Ionta. A Silver Award in Mathematics is presented to Daniel Gao and Pavel Spiska, ex aequo. A Gold Award in Science is presented to Anthony Ionta. A Silver Award in Science is presented to George Garcia and Pax Ardens, ex aequo. Congratulations, gentlemen. In addition, I call your attention to the program, which indicates the 81 members of the senior class who were nominated by our faculty to the National Honor Society. They were chosen because of their past, present, and expected future demonstration of outstanding scholarship, character, leadership, and service. Congratulations to each of them. Please stand and be recognized.
At PrEP, we talk frequently about educating the whole person, putting a premium on achieving excellence in all we do, and recognizing God in all things. Those who combine excellence in academics and athletics model a great commitment and enthusiasm for life, both inside and outside of the classroom. Refusing to compromise their pursuit of excellence in any way. For participating in one or more varsity sports while maintaining a cumulative GPA of 3.7 or higher, thus graduating with honors. We are pleased to recognize the following seniors with the St. Peter's PrEP Scholar Athlete Award. Please stand as your name is called, and please hold your applause until all recipients have been recognized. Christopher Anderson, Pax Ardanes, Suvan Bhatt, Antonio Caligari, Christopher Sorbonne, Connor Chapman, Michael Charis, Aiden Christman, James Conti, Matthew Cugliari, Kevin Diaz, Adrian Dukey, John Egan, Colin Elliott, Sean Emmert, Michael Farrell, Tyler Fearon, Brendan Finnerty, Cameron Garland, David Gerges, Samuel Gilhawley, Alexander Gray, Aiden Guarnuccio, Alexander Gudaitis, Gabriel Guedes, Daniel Hagen, James Henry, Salvatore Imbornone, Anthony Ionta, Maciek Kowalski, Samuel Leonti, Ethan McMillan, Owen Matz, Jack McGinley, David Mazzina, Brian Mikovits, Matthew Morera, Luke Morrison, Benjamin Norris, Michael O'Neill, Daniel Honorato, Raymond Ortiz Jr., Zach Oswald, Tyler Parado, Thomas Pelliccio, Jay Post, Jack Riley, Melvin Saldua, Gabriel Santiago, Alejandro Schnettler, Matthew Schreier, Cody Simon, Shepard Swift, Kevin Tierney, Brady Truppner, Victor Tyne, Michael Oy, Nicholas Oy, Peter Vasquez, Joseph Vuolo, Alexander Wasden, Declan Wieda. Congratulations. At this time, we would like to present two awards in memory of PrEP alumni who distinguished themselves as scholar athletes. John McGovern, who died in 1988, was an extremely well-liked and respected member of the class of 1980. He was especially admired for his leadership and his dedication to the spirit of teamwork that he brought daily to the PrEP basketball program. A number of his classmates created this award to be presented annually to a scholar athlete who best exemplified those attributes. And this year, we are pleased to present the John McGovern Award to William White. Jeff Cachel, a late member of the class of 89, was an honor student and four-year athlete who competed in our baseball program. Jeff was a fierce competitor whose perseverance, commitment, and leadership embodied a true PrEP student athlete. This award in his name is presented to that prep student athlete who most exemplified the traits and qualities that made Jeff such a respected member of our family. And this year, the Cachel Memorial Student Athlete Award is presented to Raymond Ortiz Jr. Quiet daily commitment is a virtue to which many aspire, but in practice it can be rare. And so this next achievement is truly impressive. For perfect attendance over their 4 years at prep, the following graduates are asked to stand for recognition. Luke D'Onofrio, Lukman Badamasi, Anthony Ayanta, William Note, Daniel Honorato. Congratulations.
At this point, I am pleased to introduce our speaker for the class of 2020. Hailing from Nutley, New Jersey, Suvan Bhatt came to prep from the John H. Walker Middle School. She is a scholar. Suvan has been a consistent honors student throughout his time at prep, as well as participating in both indoor and outdoor track and playing soccer. He earned a Modest Award at the end of his freshman year, was inducted in the National Honor Society in his junior year, and served as student council president in his senior year. In the fall, he will begin studies at NYU's Stern School of Business. Please join me in welcoming our speaker for the class of 2020, Suvan Bhatt.
Dr. Gomez, Mr. D'Angelo, members of the administration, faculty and staff, family, friends, and the graduating class of 2020, thank you for the honor and privilege of speaking here today. As I checked my email over the weekend sometime in late March, I, like many of you, was partially delighted to find an email stating that school was to be closed for the coming week. It felt like an early spring break, a quote-unquote COVIDcation. And in the madness of AP classes and the semester in general coming to a close, the seemingly God-given break was much appreciated. Fast forward a couple weeks, I couldn't stand not being in school, and the thought of having graduation at all was all of a sudden in question. Yet, here we are, the class of 2020, and their very carefully chosen two guests, celebrating the end of an adventure. My fellow prep brothers, our time has come to embrace the reality of adulthood, college life, and endless financial burden. To graduate in these circumstances is extraordinary, unprecedented, and unfortunate. But though we are 6 feet apart, I feel that we have never been more together. Together, such an ironic yet fitting word to be the theme for this year. We all heard Dr. Gomez say it over the loudspeaker, quite honestly, too many times, but little did we know it would speak volumes about our time here at prep. When I look back at my 4 years here, I see a well-rounded, wholehearted experience. From preseason sports camps to Friday night lights, cave-in football games, to clubs and activities, I, like many of you, sought out my path at prep through its experiences and offerings. I recall times walking into Mr. Keating's room only to find myself walking out with piles of busy work, and other times when I was laughing at my classmates coming back from Milano's a year too early, only to be caught by Mr. Morris. I'm sure that many of you share these moments, these little anecdotes, all of which make your time at prep special and significant. I remember calling an alumnus during a phone-a-thon, pleading with him to donate to the school. And we talked for a little, and he had this to say about his time at prep. Mind you, he is now legally considered a senior. He told me that what you will remember about prep most is not the grades you got, but how hard your classes were and how you and your friends somehow made it out alive. You won't remember the times you sat the bench when you felt like you should have gotten playing time. You'll remember the sweat and hard work of those practices and the moments throughout your seasons that formed friendships. And you won't remember that note you didn't hit during a concert. Mind you, he was in the band. You'll remember those late night walks to the light rail, laughing with your pals. Trust me, he said, I have been going to these reunions for a while, and that's what we remember. Because that, in the end, is what high school is all about. It's about the little moments. I think that all of you will be with me when I say that this school has molded the clay of my personality, characteristics, and strengths in a way that no other school could have. Its perseverance to graduate us as better men will undoubtedly hold significance in the years to come. We have much to celebrate. We have the stepping stones in front of us, some of us to college, others to trade, and still others serving our country. A round of applause to that. It is in this diversity of paths that we will spread the name of prep to the world and our brilliance along with it. The Jesuit values and ideals that prep has instilled in us will allow us to overcome and fight for better and more. And as we expand our horizons and branch out into our own individual lives, we will look back at our time at prep with pure brotherly nostalgia, the type of feeling that is certain to bring people back for the alumni reunions. You know, I actually look forward to that time when we are as old as our parents, no offense, and reconvene and celebrate the wonders of our high school years. So yes, we are graduating amidst a pandemic. And yes, our country is hurting now more than ever, and rightfully so. But I couldn't think of a better time to graduate. Because the part about tragedy and misfortune that people often overlook is becoming. Becoming, bettering, and blossoming all result from unfortunate circumstance if you allow it to. So, here's to the class of 2020, the most courageous, unforgiving, best looking, gifted, funny class Grandin Warren has ever had. Let this graduation, as weird as it may be, sink in. There's not going to be one like this for a very, very long time. And I think that's something to brag about. I'd like to once again thank everyone here that makes prep prep, the parents and family that came out today to support us, and my parents and sister, who I obviously would not be here without. And finally, from the bottom of my heart, I would like to thank all of you, my classmates, friends, and brothers, who have made my experience and each other's experiences one for the books. Though it may seem like we are departing, I know that these streets will always keep us together, together, together. Thank you.
Suvan, thank you for your words today and for many contributions you've given to prep over the last 4 years. On behalf of the faculty, we have presented you with the Vincent J. Kennedy Class of 39 Award as the Speaker of the Class of 2020. So once again, thank you and congratulations. Next, we are proud to present a number of awards to outstanding members of our senior class. First is the Reverend John Browning Class of 46 Award that was inaugurated in 1998 on the occasion of Father Browning's death. Father Browning was a Jersey City native and a member of the prep class of 46, and as a young Jesuit priest, he returned to prep, where for the next 35 years he served as the driving force behind HAP, the Higher Achievement Program. He was also a teacher, a counselor, principal, whose work was characterized by a tremendous sense of humility and service. This award is presented to a young man modeling the virtues that Father Browning lived with such distinction: courage, wisdom, and the humble service in pursuit of justice. We are proud to present the Browning Award today, ex aequo, to Bryson Shipman and Luke D'Onofrio. Congratulations. Our next award is the Jerome Peterson Class of 92 Award. Jerome passed away in February of 2001, and while his life may have been short, his impact at Prep was anything but. His time at Grandin Warren as a student, athletic trainer, and HAP teacher was characterized by good humor, deep faith in God, and selfless generosity to the Prep community. He had the gift of bringing people together, and in him, all found common ground. He was a man for all seasons, and this award is presented to a senior who models the virtues that Jerome Peterson lived with great distinction: a gentle manner, good humor, faith, and generous service to Prep. We are proud to present the Jerome Peterson Award to Joseph Duty. The Agape Award was established by an alumnus and his wife, and its name holds particular significance in the Christian lexicon. Agape is the Greek word used to describe God's unconditional love for all people, a love that goes beyond what is fair, deserved, or even rational. Love that is modeled by the Good Shepherd, who leaves the 99 to find the one, and by the Father, who welcomes home the prodigal son. This award recognizes a graduate actively living a life of faith shaped by the Gospels. We are proud to present the Agape Award ex aequo to Matthew Cugliari and Aidan Guarnuccio. Congratulations. The Jesuit Schools Network Award is presented on behalf of the 65 so Jesuit high schools of the United States in support in the organization that supports the work of each school in educating young men of competence, conscience, and compassion in the Ignatian tradition. This award at Prep recognizes someone who exhibits the characteristics of Jesuit education, someone who is intellectually competent, open to growth, religious, loving, and committed to doing justice. We are proud to present the Jesuit Schools Network Award to Anthony Ionta. And finally, we present the Reverend Francis J. Shalhou Award. Father Shalhou was a longtime member of the Prep community who served for more than 30 years as guidance counselor, principal, and director of alumni relations. This award is presented annually to a young man who best exemplifies loyalty to the ideals of St. Peter's Prep and an outstanding spirit of service to the Prep community and personal development, characterized in the phrase, a man for others. This year, we are proud to present the Shalhou Award to Matt Marrera. Congratulations. Choosing a faculty speaker for graduation is no easy task, as the choices are far too numerous. Today, a proud native of the Bronx and a graduate of Catholic and Jesuit schools herself, Ms. Belkis Dalem has dedicated her career in education to helping her students recognize their own excellence while at the same time honoring the excellence of others. This year, I am pleased that Ms. Dalem, a guidance counselor and the Director of Diversity Inclusion, will deliver the faculty address to our graduates. As Ms. Dalem, please come forward.
Mr. McGovern, Dr. Gomez, Mr. D'Angelo, colleagues, parents, and class of 2020, I want to thank you for the honor of speaking to you today. during your graduation ceremony. A graduation ceremony unlike any we have ever had in the history of St. Peter's Prep. Yet here we are. Before I begin my speech, let us take a few moments of silence for those who could not be here with us today due to COVID-19. This moment of silence reminds us and them that they are truly loved and missed. As a young girl, born and raised in the Bronx, I had a different upbringing than many of my friends. I can clearly remember hot summer days such as this one with my group of friends from the neighborhood. We would hang out all day until our parents either came downstairs from their apartments to get us or called us from the windows of kitchens and living rooms and told us to come upstairs. I could count on my friends to be outside every single day of summer vacation, but could they count on me to be outside? Well, sometimes, yes, but also sometimes, no. You see, my parents made sure I was exposed to different things and different people, always. So, some days, while my friends were out, I'd be on my way to the number 4 train to head to the city. My parents made sure I went to museums, had the opportunity to travel, and always made sure to remind me that college was a requirement in our home. My upbringing on Fordham Road was different, not better or worse than any of my friends, just simply different. In my senior year of high school, I decided that going away, far away, was what would be best for me. So I decided to attend LeMoyne College in Syracuse, New York. My time at LeMoyne was rough in the beginning. I cried the first 2 months and begged my parents to come get me. You see, I was out of my comfort zone. Even though my parents did a good job of making sure I was exposed to different places and parts of New York City, they did not prepare me for life in Syracuse. No running to the corner store, no walking to my friend's house, and no hopping on the train to head to the city. Nope, just trees and snow, so much lake effect snow, and people from towns I never knew existed, like Rome, New York, and Casanova. My time at LeMoyne was an eye-opener. I realized that not everyone thought like me, and many people would make sure to let me know. In the end, however, my time at LeMoyne was memorable, and it was one of the best decisions I made. I want you to know that the decisions that you have made are the ones that are best for you. College, work, whatever it may be. At LeMoyne, I learned so many lessons, but the most important one for me was to think outside of the box. Whether you are off to college or off to work, I cannot stress this enough. Go out, be great, do different things and explore. This is a time to continue to come out of your shell. Talk to people and listen to understand. Don't be so quick to respond. I know this sounds so very cliche, but this has helped me understand so much of the world we live in today and helps me in my work every day with students and adults who are all so different from me and one another. And this is what I really want to talk to you about today, the notion of difference. Webster's dictionary defines the word as a point or way in which people are not the same. The definition never states different as being good or bad, positive or negative, just simply not the same. And this is what our year has been, different. I often think about how we began this year, pretty much the same as any year, from heart-wrenching athletic games, beautiful masses, PM in the AM, amazing musicals and plays, we were together, supporting one another through it all. Who knew that we would be together like we had always been, and then together in a different kind of way. Being away from our physical school building tested our community in ways I don't think any of us were ready for. Some of us felt unsure because we just didn't know what to expect. We were so accustomed to our lives before that this new life was sometimes difficult to get used to. But look at us now. We are together in the best possible way, but also in a different way and at a different location, but we are here. You are here and you made it. Through it all, you made it to this very important occasion, and for that, we are truly blessed. But of course, there are so many questions that we don't have the answers to just yet. as educators, guidance counselors, or anyone in the helping profession, that is a really hard thing to admit sometimes. In writing this speech, I realized there is a lot I do not know. Not knowing what to expect personally makes me anxious. But there is something I do know, and I am 100% certain of this. You, class of 2020, are who we need. Class of 2020, this is me speaking to you directly. You are braver than so many of us. You are out here letting your voices be known, living through a pandemic, engaging in difficult conversations with friends and family, using social media in its best possible way to help educate and inform others about what matters to you. Because, let's be real, we were worried about you all a couple of years back with some of those questionable challenges that you all were presented with on said social media, like the Cinnamon Challenge, remember that one? Some of you are out in your towns at protests, walking with the Black Lives Matter movement. And as a woman who is half black, I see you and I thank you. You are working to create a different world for yourselves, inspiring us and teaching us what it means to be strong, to hold it together when you want to fall apart, to keep moving to the light together so that darkness won't win. My father has a saying, everyone has their time and everything has its season, and this is yours. Things will be different, but as we know, different is not always bad. Different actually gives us the room and opportunity to create and grow and make it what we want. As the moderator of the Student Diversity Board, I am so impressed when I see students having the opportunity to present in front of their peers and adults alike. Many times I get nervous for the students and I let them know. When I have let them know of my nervousness, I can tell you I get the same response. That response is, Miss Dallum, we got this. I usually give them a little side eye, and then I say, okay, I trust you. Today, I tell you, without the side eye, I trust you 100%. Congratulations, gentlemen. Go be great. Thank you.
Ms. Dallum, thank you. Thank you. We will present you with the Charlie Rooney Award, named in honor of Charlie Rooney, who was a member of the faculty at St. Peter's Prep for 38 years, retiring in 1985. Mr. Rooney embodied all that makes a prep teacher memorable: scholarship, humor, dedication, dependability, and a deep grounding in Ignatian principles. And it is fitting that we honor his memory with an award to the faculty speaker at graduation each year. And thank you again, Ms. Dallum. Each day, the tireless work of our faculty and staff helps to make prep such a wonderful place. Each member of our faculty and staff has left our students with memories, influences, and inspiration that will stay with them forever. On behalf of the class of 2020, I ask all members of the faculty and staff present to please stand at this moment now and to be recognized and thanked. Thank you. I also offer special recognition to the members of the faculty and staff who have devoted at least 20 years of service to St. Peter's Prep and earned the Bene Merenti Award. In a moment, I will ask our Bene Merenti awardees to stand as I call their names and the years they first began their service at PrEP. Please remain standing until the list has been completed. Father John Mullen, 1970. Mr. James Horan, 1974. Mr. Rich Hansen, 1983. Ms. Liz Walsh, 1985. Ms. Catherine Ford, 1988. Mr. Jim Dondero, 1988. Mr. John Irvin, 1989. Myself, also in 1989. Mr. Arvin Saw, 1990. Ms. Grace Guallario, 1990. Ms. Diane McCabe, 1992. Ms. Mary Phyllis Lucretio, 1992. Ms. Janice Martineau, 1994. Mr. Richard Peters, 1997. Mr. Hugo Elo, 1997. Ms. Cecilia Collins, 1998. Mr. Anthony Verdi, 1999. And Mr. Steve Kazalitz in 1999. And today, I am pleased to induct two new members to this group, having completed two decades of service to the PrEP community. Ms. Ella Glazer, a member of the mathematics department, could not be with us today. And this time I would ask Ms. Rosalie Romano, chairperson of the World Languages Department, to please stand and be recognized for reaching this milestone. There is one more group here today who deserves thanks and congratulations for their part in making today possible. I ask all parents and guardians of today's graduates to please stand. Commencement is not simply a rite of passage. It is an acknowledgement of 4 years of success, of sacrifice, and of support. Parents and guardians of our graduates, you have entrusted St. Peter's PrEP with your sons, and PrEP has been blessed by this gift. More than anyone else, you are responsible for having provided your sons with the grounding, the direction, and the spirit that have brought them to this happy day. As their first and best teachers, I hope you will take great pride in all that they have achieved. And graduates, understand with your hearts that greatness is never achieved without love and support. And never forget that what you have achieved and what you celebrate today was realized through the love and faith of those who have supported you. I would ask our graduates and faculty and staff to please acknowledge our parents and guardians for all that they have done for the class of 2020. Thank you. Now we will recognize the graduating class. In a moment, I will ask Mr. Lucretio to please lead our graduates in a procession in three separate groups to the stage to be recognized by name. I'd ask the graduates to please maintain the social distance with the person in front of you. And when you reach the stage, please come forward and stand at the marker to have a picture taken by our photographer with Dr. Gomez and with me. So Dr. Gomez, I present to you, members of the class, the St. Peter's PrEP class of 2020, and I can attest to you that they have successfully completed their course of studies, and they have been conferred diplomas of graduation. In a moment, I will ask Mr. Furlong and Mr. Morris to return to the podium to call out these names, and would ask that you please hold applause until each group of graduates has been recognized.
Austin Lawson Hogman. Cum laude, Colin Lemke. Quentin Lemon, not present with us. Alejandro Leon. Cum laude, Samuel Leonte. Cum laude, Luca Lerner. Brian Liriano. Tyler McCanka. Cum laude, Ethan McMillan. Liam McGuire. Brennan Mallett. Magna cum laude, Stephen McKino. Jelani Mason, not present with us. Cum laude, Joseph Mastandria, not present. Cum laude, Owen Matz. Graziano Mazzella, not present. Cum laude, Jack McGinley. Liam McGovern. Christian Mejia. Hendry Mejia. Daniel Merchell, not present. Cum laude, David Mezzina. Cum laude, Brian Mikovits. Juan Miranda, not present. Magna cum laude, Matthew Morera. Cum laude, Luke Morrison. Lucas Motier. Kittrick. Thomas Nowitzki, not present. Brandon Negron, not present. Brendan Nestor. Magna cum laude, Benjamin Norris. William Note, not present. Alexander Novak. Cum laude, Michael Novicio. Cum laude, Jake Nowak. Samuel O'Flanagan. Congratulations.
Michael O'Neill, not present. Connor O'Bara. Michael Allmuller. Cum laude, Daniel Honorato. Gabriel Orbe. Magna cum laude, Raymond Ortiz, Jr. Cum laude, Zach Oswald. Cum laude, Nicholas Paolini. Cum laude, Tyler Harado. Cum laude, Thomas Pelliccio. Mateo Pereira. Jeremy Perez. John Petrosino, Jr. Cum laude, J. Post. Alexander Prescott. Props not present. Devin Quinones, not present. Dylan Quintana. Christopher Quintas. Liam Reagan. Sergio Restrepo, not present. Cum laude, Jack Riley. Cooper Rogan. Gabriel Rothkegel. Joseph Rubino. cum laude, Salvatore Russo. James Ryan. Cum laude, Melvin Saldua. Magna cum laude, Andrew Santana. Cum laude, Gabriel Santiago. Cum laude, Andrew Schmutter. Magna cum laude, Alejandro Schnettler. Cum laude, Matthew Schreier. Aiden Severowski. Christopher Shepherd. Congratulations.
Bryson Shipman. Byron Shipman. Alexei Shulov, not present. Benjamin Silver, not present. Cody Simon, not present. Zubin Sood. Giovanni Sotomayor. Magna cum laude, Pavel Spiska, not present. Jelani Sweet. Cum laude, Shepherd Swift. Magna cum laude, Jason Tarantino. Jonathan Thiel, not present. Cum laude, Kevin Tierney. Louis Tolentino, not present. Joshua Torres, not present. Cum laude, Brady Truppner. Tyler Tucker, not present. Magna cum laude, Victor Tyne. Cum laude, Michael Euler. Magna cum laude, Michael Oy. Cum laude, Nicholas Oy. Magna cum laude, Peter Vasquez. Thank you. Velasquez. Cum laude, Joseph Vuolo. Robert Walker. Cum laude, Alexander Wasden. Desmond Watkins. Cum laude, Declan Weida. Nicholas West, not present. William White, not present. Peter Whitehead. Ryan Whitworth. Andrew Williams. Mason Woodard. Glenn Wright Jr. Isaiah Wright, not present. Christian Yanez. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
It's good to see you. Very, very, very good to see you. Trustees, parents, guardians, faculty, administration, and staff, one more time, let's give it up for the class of 2020. Welcome to the club, gentlemen. So good, so good. Thank you to all for being a part of this long and glorious tradition. Even though experienced in a new way, it is a long and glorious tradition celebrating all that we are as a school community, the past, the present, and the future. Gentlemen, you did it. Think of what you have acquired. Just think with me for a second. The ability to reason, to articulate, to decipher, to understand, to create, to evaluate, to forgive, to ask for forgiveness, to choose, to pray, and hopefully to love more deeply. You've also acquired some best friends for life. And this, gentlemen, is what we mean by prep for life. This is all a part of you now. This is who you are. And think of what it took to reach this moment. Think of the long days. Those long days sometimes followed by that long commute and practice and homework and tests and papers and some anxieties and some mistakes and of course some laughs. And then there's the next day where you hit repeat, and the next day you hit repeat, repeat, repeat over 4 years. And think of yourself at the end of some of those long days where you felt so worn out or drained or exhausted that you looked at yourself in the mirror and you said, what a piece of work. What a piece of work. My hope, though, that if that exhaustion came from truly giving your best, all that you got, that you actually remember the lines that follow the phrase, "What a piece of work." It's William Shakespeare's Hamlet, who so eloquently says, and I paraphrase just a bit, "What a piece of work is a human, how noble in reason, how infinite in faculty, in form and moving, how express and admirable, in action, how like an angel, in apprehension, how like a god, the beauty of the world, the paragon of animals." What a piece of work. I hope that you realize that it was through the exhaustion of giving your best that you brought true beauty to the world, and therefore, consequently, gave glory to God. If you developed that one skill above all, to utilize your talents to the best of your ability to give glory to God, then we can truly say that St. Peter's Prep is a sacred world of learning, a sacred world of formation. And for that, we are forever grateful. And as we shared earlier, parents, of course, we're grateful for you. And this day is for you as well. A chance to celebrate the gift that is your son, and a chance for you to recall, perhaps in disbelief, how much he has grown. Not just since his first steps into prep, but since his first steps ever. Think about those for a second. I'm sure you can picture them. Think about that first smile. And maybe, just maybe, remember the first time he looked you in the eye and said, "I love you." Sam Levinson writes, "Each newborn child arrives on earth with a message to deliver to humanity. Clenched in that little fist is some particle of yet unrevealed truth, some missing clue which may solve the enigma of life's destiny. Therefore, he or she must be treated as sacred." As we recognize terrific accomplishments today and remember so many more through the stories that we will continue to tell, let us rejoice in the sacredness of these graduating seniors. Sacred because they are gifts from God. Sacred in that they all grow up on their own wonderfully uneven and completely unpredictable timetable. Young men, each who, as Ignatius would say, has the ability to set the world on fire with lives filled with heroic actions and heroic virtues. Again, class of 2020, welcome to the club. Let's go prep. Thank you. Okay, even though you didn't learn the fight song this year, I was a little disappointed. It's the one thing I was disappointed with. We are proud to continue a time-honored tradition at a prep graduation with the singing of our alma mater, Pride and Glory. So I invite the members of the class of 2020 and all the alumni present to stand and join in the singing of Pride and Glory. The words are on the back of the program, just in case you forgot them. Grab a seat, men. Just a couple quick thank yous before Father Mullen leads us in prayer. I'd like to thank Mr. Robert Furlong, Mr. Michael Settembrino, Mr. Mike Duran, Miss Mary Phyllis Lucretio, Miss Diane Casaza, Ms. Thomas Santana, and Ms. Grace Galerio for coordinating today's ceremony. And certainly we want to thank Mr. Kevin Albers and Prep's operations staff for creating a beautiful setting for us today. So let's give it up for them. I now invite Father Mullen to close our ceremony with prayer.
Should we stand for our final prayer? Thank you. Jeremiah the prophet tells us something of God's desires for each one of us. He writes, "I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." And so let us pray. God of hope and new beginnings, send down your spirit upon these prep graduates. Be one step ahead of them as they plan the road that lies ahead in these formidable times. Make them young men of integrity, faithful to the traditions of their faith and the ideals of St. Peter's Prep. Fill them with the courage to make right choices that are just and merciful. In their love, help them appreciate the differences among cultures and races as the many manifestations of your all-encompassing love. Bless them with a generous and compassionate heart, so they can be the voices of hope that lead us to true racial reconciliation. Give them a love of your creation, so they embrace the stewardship of our planet, which you have entrusted to our care. We make our prayer to you, O God. You delight in all people, O God, beyond all names, who we call Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Congratulations, everyone.